We use collages as a working tool, but we use collages as a lens. On a technical level, the collage has many ups and downs, and I'm going to talk about a few of them. But we can talk about it as a technique. We can talk about it as a way of doing an image, and I will address it. But we can also talk about it as a way in which we can look at the world, as a way in which we can propose an image of the world. So for us, the collage is simultaneously a tool and a way of thinking architecture. But the collage is never alone. As I said, we always, always, always start with the plan. The plan dictates rules, and until the plan is not somehow existing, there's no collage, because the collage is the perfect counterpoint to the plan. The plan, as I said, narrates facts. It's measurable, it's dry, you can discuss it with a client, and the client can disagree with you, and even we can disagree about something on a plan, and we can explain why, because it's too big, too narrow, too tall. But the collage, no. The collage, because it comes as a result of a certain plan, of a certain idea of architecture, the collage is like a punch in the face. Either you accept it, either you deal with it, or you reject it completely. It has, you know, it deals with your guts. It deals with something that is visceral, something that you cannot really rationally explain. It's either yes or no. And it's fantastic when we have the chance to talk with other architects, with, you know, when we talk among each other in the office, when we talk with clients, and the collage somehow proves to make so much sense. They get it. They completely understand it. And the collages, they help us to work in a limbo, to propose exactly what we're going to have there.